Thank you, Sec Edwin. Gandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. As of this time, we have not received any official notice of the reported temporary restraining order supposedly issued by the Supreme Court. Based on the reported issuance of a TRO, we are preparing a motion for reconsideration or the lifting of the TRO. The reported TRO has not been substantiated to exist pending receipt by the respondents through the Office of the Solicitor General. Hence, the status quo, which is the existence of the watchlist order against the Arroyos, remains. In view thereof, I have ordered the Bureau of Immigration and requested the Secretary of the Department of Transportation and Communication to direct the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, or CAAP, and the Ninoy Aquino International Airport, or NAIA, management and personnel to exhaust all actions to implement the watchlist order against the Arroyos. Consequently, all law enforcement officers are directed to assist the said authorities in carrying out the same. They are also directed to report any attempts by the Arroyo couple and their entourage to board any international, commercial, or chartered flight to whatever destination outside of the Philippines. We take the position that upon the filing of a motion for reconsideration or the lifting of the TRO, the effectivity of said TRO shall be deemed as having been stayed and held in abeyance pending the resolution of the same. Maraming salamat po.
Right. First question from Mia Gonzalez from Business Mirror.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Ma'am, what are you doing to ensure that they would not slip out of the country undetected?
We have just issued this directive. We directed the BI, and I just requested Secretary Mar Rojas to also issue a similar directive to the CAAP and the NAIA to implement the watchlist order against the Arroyos, meaning that in the event that the Arroyos appear at the airports and other ports of exit between now, at this very moment, and up to the resolution of our motion for reconsideration, which we'll definitely file as soon as we receive an official copy of the TRO, then they need to bar them from leaving, because that is our position. The TRO is deemed as stayed or deferred until the resolution of the urgent motion for reconsideration.
Ma'am, has any specific law enforcement group been tasked to keep a close watch over them?
Well, aside from the BI personnel itself and the airport authorities, we have advised the NBI, and we are also advising the PNP, any appropriate law enforcement authorities, that they should be on the lookout for the Arroyo couple's attempt to immediately leave the country on the strength of this TRO, the official copy of which we have not yet received. And we need to do this because of confirmed information or reports from NAIA as well as BI that the Arroyos had in fact made bookings today, beginning with 4 o'clock PR 501, and then 5 p.m. flight SQ 919, the bookings were canceled because they did not appear, but there were bookings, and then followed by three other bookings for today at 7:35 for PR via PR 505, 7:55 via SQ 921, and the last booking for today is 9 o'clock, although this is still being checked, possibly through Dragon Air. And most of these flights, well, I can confirm that the first three flights I mentioned are bound for Singapore. So there is this intention to immediately leave the country. And that is puzzling to us. Well, they issue the TRO. That's why we are supposed to, that's why we are definitely filing an urgent motion for reconsideration.